All right, amazingly, she actually has a better Rotten Tomatoes score than Black Panther. Gloria Allred is here. Seeing Allred is the documentary. We've seen the Netflix billboards around town. Gloria, nice to see you this morning.
You thanks too, Sam. Here. Thank
How
you.
Long did it take them to persuade? I mean, was there a reticence on your part?
There was. It took them about 2 years to persuade me to do Seeing Allred. And I was a little bit reticent because I really wanted to make sure that it was about the clients whose voices are generally not heard but who should be heard, and because what they have to say about the injustices against them is really important. And I also was reluctant to give up some of my privacy, but I made that trade-off, and I'm just very, very happy about the film. I think they did a great job, and I'm just very pleased that Netflix is broadcasting it all over the world to 100 million subscribers and translated it into 25 different languages so that it's available. And my hope is that Seeing Allred is going to empower women and those who have not had a voice, have not been afforded their rights, to stand up and know what action and steps that they can take to win change and to win respect and dignity and equality.
We're going to run a clip that I would say is decades old. And before we do, okay, are things better in 2018 than they are in 1980, 1990?
They're better than they were, but we still have not won all of our rights. And what's important is no one has ever given women any rights, including the right to vote. For the right to vote, we had to fight for 72 years to win it. It's been 95 years. We still have not won the passage of the Equal Rights Amendment to the United States Constitution. We have a long, long way to go. But what we see in this film is we see persons being transformed. We see individuals who are victims becoming survivors and becoming fighters for change and being successful in the change they want. We see them becoming what Gandhi said was, be the change you want to see in the world. And so that's what I want people to take away from this film, how they can also matter and make a difference in this world for the future, for their daughters and for their sons.
If you don't think Gloria has been at this for a while or it doesn't come naturally to her, this is from the Dinah Shore show. And Dinah's sort of doing a monologue at the front of the show, listing the expectations that husbands have of their wives. Watch this.
4, be attired in a negligee. 5, have a meal prepared within an hour. And 6, be attired in a negligee. Gloria Allred, are you? Hi, Gloria.
Hi, Dinah.
Where are you from?
I'm an attorney in Los Angeles.
Ah, welcome. And how would you feel if your husband presented you with a list like that?
Well, Dinah, I think we have a uterus and a brain, and they both work. And I think it's very insulting to women.
Listen, I think you ought to be definite about this. Don't just tiptoe around it.
Oh, Gloria.
When did you realize that the cameras were part of the equation?
Well, when I realized that the court of public opinion is very important in helping to change laws and helping to change the minds of legislators, and I might add, to also open up the minds of judges who supposedly are only going to decide a case based on what they hear and what is admissible in the courtroom. But the reality is that we're all affected by the court of public opinion. And so we needed to make change, something that was possible. We needed to help women to understand that they need to abandon fear. Fear is a weapon that has been used to keep them down in their place and denied of their rights. So to understand that we need to be available, there was no internet at the time, there were no cell phones. We need to be seen, we need to be heard, we need to matter, we need to call out injustice, and we need to help people to know how they can win change. That's what it's all about. So I realized that early, and I tried to become that person who could be a model for what we want women to be, which is to stand up and speak out for their rights in their home, in their families, in their workplaces, and in their community.
I imagine, for some reason, that you, in your office, often have these private meetings. Somebody comes to you,
yes,
and says, are there ever times where you suggest to them, don't go forward?
Many times. Actually, I don't ever tell anyone, Sam, to speak out publicly or not speak out publicly. What I do is I help people to understand what are the benefits and what are their risks. What is their goal? Does this help? Does this hurt? meet the goal. I mean, we do many, many confidential settlements against very, very high profile, powerful people. And you will never know the name of the person who was victimized. You will never hear the person, the high profile person who committed the injustice, because the victim may wish to have her privacy. She or he is entitled to that privacy. And that's a decision that they will make. Life is very complicated. They get to make that decision. I'm there to support them in whatever decision they make, if I agree that it's the best decision for them.
I suspect some people would hear that. Is it ever a cop-out? You know, Mr. X just has to write a check and it all goes away.
Well, I don't call it that because, again, my job is to support my client who is the victim, because I represent victims. Mm. And I'm not there to second guess her decision or his decision. Look, I know the press always wants to know everything. I don't blame them for that. That's your job. That's everybody's job. It's not my job. My job is to be a victim advocate, to represent my client. We've won hundreds of millions of dollars for our clients over the years that we've been practicing, when they've been victims of sexual harassment, civil rape, sexual assault, discrimination. This is what we do. So that's a decision that they can make. It's often a difficult decision, but they get to make it, and I'm there to support them. But the point is, they're empowered. Whatever they do, whether it's private, whether it's public, they have decided to take steps. I have so many people, since the Me Too movement especially, reaching out and saying, what are my rights legally? What are my options? What are the benefits and risks of those choices? And then they make the decision. So that's always good when people want to know what their rights are, because knowledge is power. And as lawyers, we should empower them so they can know what they wish to do.
There we go. Seeing Allred is streaming on Netflix right now. Morning News jumps back for Thursday in just a minute. Gloria, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Sam.